situation in Kazakhstan smart meter as a kind of solution for the smart building, advantages and disadvantages of the smart meter, and we will talk about our plan, what we're going to do within the next year or so in Nazarbayev University. This is something which we are planning actually to do in the next year. This presentation is not coming from the result. So, but let's get back actually to the definition. What is the reason that, to the problem statement, what is the reason that we are looking actually for the smart city and smart building? All you gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, you are familiar actually with this specific topic, and you know that the main reason which we are looking for the smart city and smart building specifically is first, energy consumption. So the other one is carbon emission reduction. Therefore, let's look at actually to the energy consumption and carbon emission generation by Kazakhstan in this stage. I can tell you that this couple of graphs have been taken from these resources. If you look at the Kazakhstan electricity consumption, so you see that for the last decade, the electricity consumption has got significantly increased in Kazakhstan. So we don't want to talk in detail what is the reason that that one significantly increased, of course, because the country is actually developing very fast. But in the meantime, so that's a point of, you know, that's a point of basically concern that how we're going to have to deal with this actually electricity consumption for the next 20 years. The other thing is, if you look at the carbon emission generation, and if you look at the CO2, so the position of Kazakhstan as compared to the entire country in which we are making carbon, so and we are spreading carbon into the atmosphere these years. So it's not that much bad if you look at that one, but if you look at the population of the Kazakhstan as compared to the population, so CO2 generation per capita, so it's something really significant. I can tell you that just United Arab Emirates, Australia, Saudi Arabia, so and probably United States, they are much faster than Kazakhstan. The other countries are slower. So and this one will make significant, this one has been made significant actually intention the government of Kazakhstan to do very fast reaction. That's the reason that government of Kazakhstan is really eager actually to implement renewable energy as fast as possible. There is a plan for 2030, and after that another plan for actually 2050. So, but let's get back to the main topic. So, which we're going to talk about the smart building. So, in terms of the smart building, so these days, more or less, we are talking about the smart building. So, the things which is coming to our mind, based on the definition, or I can tell you that based on the current state of the art, is a kind of building which is totally automated. So a building which we have been using different kind of sensor, actuators, you know, thermometers, we have been using different kind of, you know, basically techniques to collect information and data. That one is usually talking about the smart building. That one is inspiring in our mind that there is a system which we can actually, you know, get information over our mobile. So, or perhaps tablet. So, but however, whether this is really smart and this is something which we are looking for or not, so this is a big question. So whether this is an automated system or this is quite smart, this is something which we're going to talk about it today. So in terms of the current definition of the smart building, so even if you look at actually to the Oxford Dictionary definition, which is talking about the smart building as a home, equipped with lighting, heating, and electronic devices that can be controlled remotely by a smartphone computer, there are still some concerns. So about whether this system is smart or not. So first of all decisions are initiated not by a smartphone, but by smart inhabitants. For instance, if you're going to actually do some kind of action, so the building, the apartment is not doing any kind of action for you. This is you, which you're going to do the action using your mobile phone or tablet. So therefore, this concern is still available. How this guy is actually intelligent? The other thing is, this definition reflects the current state of the market. This is now available, so in the market. So we got different kind of the system, which you can actually, you know, different kind of the company, which you can ask them to come to your apartment and make the automated system for you. This is not something that we are looking for, at least for the long term, for the next many years. Very often, smart buildings are confused with just automated buildings. This is something which I discussed about that one. And most commercial products can provide only the ability to use a remote control and predefined behavior of different engineering systems, rather than the intelligence system. But recently, CRP working group, so basically they have to provide another definition, which is much closer to our long-term goal, which is smart building and actually smart city. An intelligent building is a dynamic and responsive architecture that provides every occupant with productive, cost-effective, and environmentally approved condition through a continuous interaction among all elements. If you look at here, it's talking about interaction between the elements. It's talking about the interaction between different parts of the appliances inside of your apartment, inside of your building. Even furthermore, it's talking about the interaction between different parts of the apartment. Because right now, so basically the apartment cannot talk to each other. This is a significant challenge in the entire world. I can tell you that one of the significant challenges in the entire world is most of the apartment, most of the houses, most of the flats, they are not network connected. So most of them, I can tell you that they are independent. So specifically for the large country, like a Casa de Sal, even like a upstream. So they have no active monitoring system, like as a transmission system. In transmission system, talking from the electrical engineering point of view, in transmission system, we got dispatching center. Dispatching center can see each and every city construction. So based on dispatching center information, we can make a decision how to flow the power to different one of the cities. But right now, in distribution station, we don't have that much monitoring system. So we don't know exactly, when I'm talking that we don't know, so it's the concern of most of the country in the world, we don't know how much is the total loss in distribution section. However, this information for many years has been available for the transmission system. Therefore, this is another concern. So we have no centralized control system. However, so we know that so basically recently in Switzerland, in Germany, in different parts of the world, so based on last presentation, the central monitoring system has been initiated and that one is working really well. So this could be helpful actually to our future mission. But I can tell you that this is still a challenge. So building automation is another thing. We still have the conventional building, so and all of the buildings are not automated. So right now, we're going to go from the independent system, from the conventional building, so to jump to the smart building. Do we need really to automate it at first, and after that make it smart or not? This is the question which we're going to answer in within the next couple of years, next year or next couple of years in this specific project in Azerbaijan. So, however, in Kazakhstan, so I'm talking about the Kazakhstan, but there are lots of companies in the world, definitely. So there are different kind of the companies which you are providing automated system for your apartment. But that one is really expensive. You have to talk with them if they're going to make it for you smart, so they will charge you for in the range of some $1,000. Which of course the people cannot afford just to make it on automation. You know? Now how are we going to actually to switch from the conventional system to the automated system? That one is a concern. Maybe not a challenge, but it's still a concern. So, but one of the solutions which we think, one of the solutions, because there are lots of solutions, but one of the solutions which we think is going to be useful is using a smart meter. Using a smart meter, so we can implement the brain for each and every apartment. And by a smart meter, apartment can tie together. Not only apartment can tie together, but also apartment can tie to the central system. Apartment from one city even can tie to the apartment to the other city. So that's the reason we think that if we can focus on a smart meter, I'm saying, again, I'm emphasizing this is one solution. So that one is going to become useful. But let's look into the meter technology. So more or less you got familiar with different kinds of the meter. So analog meter, which all of us probably have been grown up with that one. So that one has been initiated in 1981. So after the automatic meter reading, which was a quantum meter which would send the information to the database or to the electricity provider, that one has been actually constructed and commercialized in 1990. And recently we have got AMI, Advanced Meter Infrastructure, which is a quantum meter which I can tell you that right now, more or less the entire apartment, so inside in the Europe, in Asia, in America, so in Australia, in Africa, I can tell you that most of the apartments in the world they are equipped with the AMI system. So this AMI system not only provides this opportunity that you are getting information from the meter side, but also you can send the information to the meter and update, for instance, the tariff inside the meter. So you can a little bit talk about
you can a little bit tighten your meter. So this system has an in-home display. This system has a payment system, and basically through this system we can a little bit manage our consumption. But what we are looking in the smart meter? So basically the things which we are looking in a smart meter. So first of all, before I'm turning to the smart meter, let's look at the advantages of the AMI. Let's highlight it, and then later we're going to see that how the smart meter can help to update this actually slide. If you look into the advantages of the AMI right now, I can tell you that we can manage consumption using AMI system, but still you have to manage. You have to think how to actually to use your electricity. I'm talking about electricity, but it's going to be effective for heat, it's going to be effective for water. Usage pattern, so that's another actually inner capability of this system. Billing accuracy. These are from the customer side point of view. The other one is service provider point of view, low profile analysis, billing accuracy and reliability. But having AMI, there is a significant concern. How are we going to convince the people? Because these advantages of the smart meter and AMI actually, and later of course the smart meter, is security and privacy. There are lots of people in the room which they are not happy to share their information. Because of the security and more important because of the privacy. How are we going to convince those people to use this smart meter? So I'm telling you that we have a project back in Australia. So basically the government has been implemented, so Energy Australia was a company order, so they have implemented AMI and they got sometimes very, very hard feedback from the customers in terms of the privacy and in terms of the billing. So there is one scenario about that one. They are working actually to modify that system. So to make a smart meter actually effective, we have to make the people happy. How are we going to make the people happy? How the people are becoming happy? That was the question. People becoming happy by earning the money, saving the money, interrupting corruption, telling good jokes sometimes to the people will make the people happy. So bringing a cup of tea or coffee, that one is something which is making more or less the people happy. Helping each other, so that one is something significant which is a form of leisure for the people. With the good food sometimes, so you can make the people happy. More comfort, this is something which we are looking for actually in the smart meter. More security, more honesty. Having a large kitchen, this is the collision for the ladies. So, good parking space, all of these spaces will make actually our customers happy. More discounts, so controlling everything with the smartphone and having sizes. These are some of those examples which we can make the people happy. That's very good. So we can actually go to the smart meter from this point of view, and we can develop the smart meter in a way which we convince the people that they have to use the smart meter. These are the options. These are the options which we're going to implement for the smart meter, hopefully, which we are planning to develop as a platform for the next year. We are planning actually to provide a system which can detect disturbance in the distribution network, the hormones which you are generating with your different appliances, and basically get rid of those disturbances and then give pure sinusoidal signal to their distribution network. So this is a technical thing which I don't want to highlight today because we don't have enough time. So anti-theft system. So in this system, we can get rid of actually robbery of the electricity, which has been an issue for the last 100 years, I can tell you that. And the people know many ways to bypass the meter. But in this system, because the meter can tie with the sensor and the meter can tie together, so we can actually get rid of this issue. Remote controlling of home appliances. This is something which is more or less available, but we are expecting to get actually in the smart meter as well. Real-time data and billing calculation bidirectional from the meter to the sensor and from the sensor to the meter, so that one is something which we are looking for. Indoor occupancy estimation. So this system should be able to detect the number of the people and the number of residents inside the apartment and adjust everything, the electricity consumption based on the number of the people available. So basically the other things, indoor air quality analysis. Air quality is something significant which is really influencing the health of the children. So you know that sometimes you are sleeping and you feel that you need to open the window. That's the reason because you've got lots of toxic gases collected inside the apartment. So the meter should be able to address this issue. The meter should be able to manage and bring everything into the normal. So we have done a kind of pilot system on this case at Nazarbayev University. I can show you after today's presentation. So in home payment is another thing. Fault detection and diagnosis of all of the appliances inside the apartment. So demand response, which is really concern of the distribution section and electricity provider, specifically when the renewable energy, so basically replacing the conventional energy. Dynamic tariff. So when we have electricity market, the first tariff should be completely dynamic. Dynamic tariff should be possible to be upgraded within 15 minutes, each 15 minutes. Energy saving using load management. You are not supposed actually to turn on whatever you want during the peak hours, but who is going to manage it? You are not supposed to manage it. This is the beauty of the smart meter, which is supposed to manage it for you. So, energy harvesting control and management for the zero energy building, so which is really hot topic. This is something that should be managed with the smart meter. Integrated with the weather forecasting. So, the meter should be able to connect to the weather forecasting system and send the energy for you today to use it 3 days later, which the temperature goes down or the temperature goes up, like as saving the money for tomorrow. So connecting to the firefighting center, so leveraging renewable energy, self-calibration, and self-operating, these are actually the advantages which we are looking in the smart meter, hopefully, at Nazarbayev University. We have developed some of them, so, but we're still working actually on this specific project, and there are some options which will make the people happy. And really, we hope that we can convince all of the people in the world. Of course, we need hardware, software, and network, so to implement such a couple of things. And as the last slide, I can tell you that what is really challenging ahead? More privatization is required. So for those countries, we are still working based on the government support. So governmental plan is required. This is the plan. There should be a deadline. So actually, until we can actually to respect that deadline and implement something, start to implement something, get the feedback, and just then modify. There should be deadline for implementation. This is exactly the same as the last one. Governmental encouraging system. The government should provide this support for those people which they're going to actually save the energy. So there should be an encouraging system. And there is a big challenge which we have to still address and talk about that one, specifically for a large city, 20 million people. So, and that one is network traffic management. If we implement everything, so there are some other options which is coming, and actually, you know, we can take it as the advantages for our smart city and hopefully smart building. We have a shared youth ready. And that shell here, this is the yard. So inside the Nazarbayev University, you can visit it during. That's a solar power plant, small solar program. We've got three wind turbines here. And we have got general geothermal infrastructure. And all of these are connected to the battery energy storage system. And the feeder of the battery energy storage system is going to this shell yard. This is actually the shell yard. Inside the shell yard, we've got all of our plus TV, refrigerator, everything. So we're going to implement and examine the smart meter which we're going to develop over this system and grab the data for the machine learning. Thank you very much, so for your attention.